Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm excited this morning to have this great opportunity to speak right into our eyes by the grace of God. The Lord has been good. It's an amazing morning, and we have to internalize, anticipate, and open our hearts to be blessed of the Lord this morning. My name is Pastor Johnston Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription every morning. And this morning I'd like us to pray, and then we will hear the voice of the King. Shall we pray? Lord Jesus, we thank you and we bless you this morning. We honor you because of your grace. We honor you because of your loving kindness. And so, Father, we ask that God, you'll minister to us in a special way this morning. We bring our worries, our fears, and things that appear obstructive in our lives to you this morning, that, Father, you will continue to establish your kingdom and you'll continue to hold us with your victorious right hand in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, because every day we sit to listen to your voice, our spiritual life is strengthened, we are motivated to follow you, and that, Lord, we continue to hold unto the faith. We want to thank you this morning for each one of us, O God, and we're asking for your mercy and favor upon our lives. Father, even in times when you have done things that are contrary to your expectation, Lord, we ask for your mercy and your forgiveness upon our lives, that God, you may continue to shine in our lives for the glory of your name. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Good morning once again. This morning I'd like to speak about a subject, silent followers. Silent followers. Now, I just want to make a statement before I read scripture to say, is not that when there is a lot of noise that work is going on, and therefore the measure of results is not based upon the noise that is made. That means visibility. The noise that is made is not necessarily a significance or a show of productivity. Praise the name of the Lord. And so this morning I would like to speak about silent followers. I read the Bible in the book of John, chapter number 19, from verse number 38. John, chapter number 19, from verse number 38. I'm reading from the New King James Version. The Bible says, after this, Joseph of Arimathea, being a disciple of Jesus, but secretly, for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. And Pilate gave him permission. So he came and took the body of Jesus, verse number 39. And Nicodemus, who at first came to Jesus by night, also came, bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pounds. Then they took the body of Jesus and bound it in strips of linen with the spices, as the custom of the Jews is to bury. Now, in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden a new tomb in whom no one had yet been laid. So there they laid Jesus, because of the Jews' preparation day, for the tomb was nearby. Praise the name of the Lord. I want you to understand that two people come into the scene at this particular time. That is Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus. Praise the name of the Lord. If you read the scripture on other versions of the disciples who wrote the Gospels, you'd find that Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, was also there. I want you to understand, then those are four individuals that came to ask, or they are the women were just watching what was going on at that particular time. But Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus are significant in this process that I'm trying to talk about. So Mary Magdalene was there, and the other Mary was sitting opposite the tomb. So those are four individuals that were there when the body of Jesus Christ was being brought down on the cross and then being taken to the tomb for burial. Now, this is what I came to talk to you about. And as a believer, you must always know, though you are visible to do what God has called you to do, though you are, you know, pursuing and focusing, or you are visible in what you do for God, never assume in your life that there are not other people who are not visible, but they believe in God and they have got their place on what to deliver, when called upon. Praise the name of the Lord. So this is very, very significant, because when Jesus was crucified, he died. But this man, the rich man, now when I looked about this word rich or prominent, another translation of this interpretation of the word rich or prominent has got to do with the deeds, the grace that was upon this man called Joseph of Arimathea. Praise the name. You can also take it literally that he was basically a rich person in terms of wealth and means. But what is further from this was that this man was full of character. He was full of grace. He was full of God's presence. Now, the Bible tells us that Joseph of Arimathea, who was a secret follower of Jesus Christ. Now, if you're so public about your faith in God, it is an okay thing. But don't underrate the people who don't talk about something sometimes. God has made us in different dimensions. God has made us in different personalities. And so don't assume that your personality is all there is, you know, in terms of the people who believe God. Now, the Nicodemus man who came to Jesus by night, saying, "What can a man do to be born again? Will a man go back to the womb of the parent? What would happen?" This was a man who came to Jesus by night. It means he had his own fears on how he was fearing to be associated with Christ. But at this opportune moment, these people who have followed Christ secretly, and those who came to Jesus by night, and Mary Magdalene, whom that the Lord had delivered some time back, they are basically at the right place, at the scene, to ensure that Jesus Christ is given a decent burial. I want therefore to proclaim to you that we have got silent followers of Christ, silent followers who will do the right thing at the right place. Don't just, you know, you see, when the disciples were being persecuted in the book of Acts, there arose a man who said, "Be very careful lest you be found to be fighting against God." You know, he said, "Lest you find yourself hitting your leg upon a prick. Be very careful. If this thing is of God, it will stand. But if it's not of God, it will pass." And he gave examples about people who had come in the name of the Lord and the Lord was not in it, and they were able to disappear. When they died, their whole dimension, or the people who gathered or coalesced around them when these people died, all those things went away. But if something is of God, it will stand. We must therefore be motivated that though we do not know a number of the people who follow Christ, there are people who silently follow Christ, and when called upon at the right time, they will rise up and protect God. Some people will say things about you in right places. You may not even know them, but they will talk because they are secret followers of God, and therefore they know what you do is in the best interest of God. And so they will support you in the right places. They'll make sure that, you know, what you're supposed to get, you might not know them, but they'll come up and give the right dimension of what you're trying to do, because they know right inside their spirit, they are followers of Christ, and therefore they will do it. They'll make sure things they're supposed to approve, they approve. They'll make sure they stand by your position. They'll protect you, because those are secret followers of Christ, silent followers. Now, when you talk about Elijah, when he confronted the prophets of Baal, we know that Elijah, when Jezebel gave the threats, Elijah ran away, and you're saying, "Oh God, let me die." But God said, "I have more thousands and thousands of prophets who have not bowed their knees to Baal." These are the people I'm talking about. And so even as you go about your business, as you go about your ministry, there are people who pray for you, you might never know them. They continue to intercede, they continue to go before the Lord, they speak on your behalf, they take your agenda to God, they continue to do it. Look at the woman who served in the temple, that when Jesus was born, he says, "Now I can die, for I have seen the Messiah." Praise the name of the Lord. These are people who labored in the temple. This specific lady labored in the temple waiting to see the Messiah. Now, you could imagine somebody just waking up every morning, going to the temple to pray until he wanted to see by her own eyes the Messiah. And when the Messiah showed up, the woman said, "Now I can die because I have seen the Messiah." Silent followers of Christ. So don't only think that the people who proclaim, the people who shout about their faith in God, of course, I know it is important to testify, but what other testimony can you have than Joseph of Arimathea going to Pilate and asking to be given permission to bury the body of Jesus Christ? This was quite a difficult moment for people. Disciples had just lost their leader. In fact, Bible tells us about Thomas who doubted that Jesus Christ would resurrect. You see, and so this was a difficult moment. But when the silent follower in the name of Joseph of Arimathea, he took the courage, he went to Pilate and asked for permission to go and bury Jesus. And Nicodemus, the one who came by night, is mentioned in this scripture as also being there. And Mary Magdalene, who had been forgiven much. They say, when you're forgiven much, you love much. So Mary Magdalene was there, and the other Mary, they were all here. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, it is not about the voice. It's not about the noise. It's not even about the activity. No. God measures us by our faith and our heart and our belief in the Lord God. This is what I came to say. So don't underestimate people who don't talk much, who don't speak much, who are not very, very active. They are right there working behind the scenes to pray, to do what they have to do in their closet, sometimes even to give their resources. Have you not had people who give lots of money to ministries and they don't want to be mentioned? They don't want to be mentioned. You see, Joseph of Arimathea did not consult anybody. He was a rich man, a prominent man, who followed Jesus secretly. At the very opportune moment, he walks to Pilate and says, "Allow me to go and bury, to bring down the body of Jesus and bury it." The big question is, all the multitudes that followed Christ over all this period, where were they? Where were the disciples? Where were they? This is a tough question. But Joseph of Arimathea was there. He was there. He secretly followed Christ. Nicodemus, the one who came by night, was there. Mary Magdalene was there. The other Mary, they were all there. And I want to tell you that then, what I'm saying is that faith in God is not about what you speak or the activities you engage in. Not necessarily. That is a good thing to do. It's good to be visible. It's good to do something for God that can be seen. But much more, what we do in our prayer closets, what we do in our prayer rooms, what we intercede to God at our time when nobody is seen is so significant, more than what is seen. And therefore, if your heart is pure, if your heart is with God, if your heart is properly sitting in the dimension of God, then I can tell you, results are imminent. Results are imminent. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The good Lord bless you. The good Lord be with you. The good Lord help you to follow Christ first from your heart where nobody sees and then to the outside. May the good Lord be with you. The good Lord bless you this wonderful Friday morning. May the Lord remove every snare. May the Lord remove every obstacle. May the Lord cause you to tower above every challenge that will come your way in the period to come. May the Lord be with you. The Lord lift you with his victorious right hand for the glory of his name. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you this morning. We give you praise and glory and honor and adoration because you are in charge and you are in control. The things we cannot do, Lord, you can do them. The things, Father, we are unable to complete, Lord, you are able to complete. The things we are unable to defend ourselves, God, you can defend us. The things we are unable to absolve ourselves, Lord, you can absolve us. Father, we thank you this morning, and I want to thank you for each one of us. I thank you for the organizations we work for. I pray in Jesus' name that God, it shall be a place of blessing, a place of lifting. Let your glory continually be upon our lives as we walk through the corridors of where we work to create impact, to bring the realities of God for the glory of your name. I want to thank you this morning, and I want to honor you. For this we pray, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. The good Lord bless you. The good Lord be with you as we continue to follow Christ in the name of the Lord. This is your host, Pastor Johnston Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription, your daily morning dose of the word of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.